Hi scholarly friends, if you want to know how to do this, then keep on watching this video. Gmail, open Gmail settings by clicking on the gear icon from the top right corner. Select See All Settings, then scroll down until you find a signature. Click Create New and name your new signature. In this section, you can simply write your name, your title, contacts or social media platform. You have 11 fonts to choose from and you can use these tabs below to style your text. Just remember to keep it simple. But if you want something like this, here's a workaround you can do instead. Open drive.google.com, click New, and open Google Docs. Click Insert, Table, add a 2x1 table, and here is where we'll build our new email signature. So we're gonna expand the table to 100 pixels. You want to do this because email has limited options for HTML and CSS, and you can't do a lot of fancy formatting, and things are going to get squished on smartphones, so better limit it to this size. Now let's move this line to the left. And here is where we will put our picture or a logo. So we'll click Insert, Image, and upload your file. And there you have it. Here you can add your tagline, link to your website or social media accounts, or phone number if you want people to contact you that way. Google Docs has loads of fonts to choose from, but Gmail only has about 10 or 11. So whatever font you use in this document is going to default to one of those 10 when you bring it into Gmail. So no need to bother with fancy fonts. Now we'll edit the table properties and remove the border. Right-click anywhere inside a table and select Table Properties. Change the table border to 0 points. You can stop here if you'd like the text to align with the top of your photo or logo. But if you want your text centered vertically next to your photo, change the cell vertical alignment to center. Let's add a horizontal line above signature to separate it from the body of messages. Select the whole table by clicking in one cell and dragging across to the other cell. You should see the content of both cells highlighted. Then click the little arrow in the upper right corner and select the option for a top border. When you do this, the menu at the top of your document should change to let you set the style of this border. The most important thing is to set the way or the thickness of the border. We cleared the way in our table properties earlier to remove the whole table border, so now we need to reset the way for this top border. If you want, you can also change the color or style of the border. Alright, then we're going to copy our signature from our Google Doc and paste it into Gmail. The Gmail signature editor doesn't allow us to create tables or do all of this formatting, but it'll allow it when pasted in from a Google Doc. Let's go back to Gmail and let's try the multiple signature feature. It will give you the flexibility to use different signatures for different situations. Click Create New, name your new signature, and paste the one we did in Google Docs. And there you have it! You can easily change your signature depending on your email. Lastly, test your new email signature. Send yourself an email and make sure to check it on your desktop, laptop computer, or smartphone. Isn't it nice? You don't have to pay for signature generator. You can do it for free in Google Docs. Let us know how you get on in the comment section below. hit the subscribe button and click on that notification bell so you will be notified on our next upload.